Welcome back to part 4 of the complex wire removal series. It's now time to pull together all of the data we've created in the previous exercises to remove our top wires. We also take our first steps into the Roto node, and I'll be showing you how to best set this up to fit your way of working. So let's jump in to Silhouette. Okay, so let's get to our Roto. Let's close up our viewer, just make sure everything's looking neat again. Just hit F to go to full screen. And I'm going to bring a Roto node over my YD noise. And we know that this shot is moving around a little bit. I don't think I can really get a good track to sort of help the Roto out on the wires themselves. So what I'm going to do is the next best thing, and that's cancel out the movement of the camera. And we already have that, don't we? We've got that through our tracker. So this is something that we're going to keep coming back to time and time again as we finish this shot. We're going to recycle, reuse lots of different types of data to sort of help us push things through. And I'm going to take the megaplate background layer. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to bring that into my Roto 1 node. So double click on that and then just Control or Command V just to paste that back in. And I will call this one, actually, we'll just leave that at megaplate 1. That's fine. So now if I come up to the top of my viewer, I can stabilize that either around the active layer, or I can stabilize it around, you know, one of the nodes. So we can take it, or we're in Roto 1 node, so stabilize it around that. So now all I'm going to be doing is kind of chasing the wire rather than chasing the wire and the camera movement. Okay, so let's come in. I'm going to go over and choose my X-spline tool. You can choose whatever tool you want to, but I like the X-spline tools. They work nicely for me. And I'm just going to come in and zoom in a little bit here. I'm going to try and take out as much of this wire as possible. So the more we can do with this map, the better. And let's get into the habit very, very early on naming our shapes, because it's gonna get really tricky soon. In fact, organization as a whole is gonna start to build up complexity. And so we need to stay on top of it. So I'm gonna call this one wire top, and it's over on the screen right. So I'm gonna call this one wire top right. And let's just move that up somewhere. We'll move to the final frame, and I'm going to come into my transform, hit T or just move over the transform, and I'm going to move this around about here. So just sort of place it where the wire would be and sort of come in here, and I'm going to hold down Control or Command just to move that into place, just like we did in Mocha, actually. Just distort that into place. Okay, cool. And let's come over to the other side, move that down there. I'm going to leave this until, or move this here just before it hits the face. And the first frame is one of those bad keyframes, not bad keyframes, bad encoding things that we saw before. So it's slightly more compressed than the other images. We just have to work with it. Okay, and then I'll just move this over here just to sort of tweak this up just a little bit. Don't want to add too many keyframes. I want to keep this as natural and smooth looking as possible. And we'll make one for the other side. So again, come back into my X-spline, move that around. There we go. Bring that back in. Maybe make this just a little bit wider. If I select these two points, hold down the Alt or Option key and just kind of move this to the left, I can change up the weighting on the X-spline. It fits in a little bit there. Then when I've done that, I'm just going to move straight to the transform tool and do most of the work with the transform tool rather than work with the individual points. Now here, it's actually really difficult to see where the transform tool is on this white or light background. Let's come into prefs and I'm going to come into colors and I'm going to change my bounding box color to something a little bit darker, maybe a dark green. Okay, hit apply on that. Makes it a lot easier to see on light backgrounds. There we go. Chase that back down. Guess round about where it is. Sort of make an informed guess, I should say, because the wire is always going to be straight. There we go. And we'll start getting a little bit more accurate when we can see that above the shoulder there. Okay. And those are our two shapes. So let's call this one wire top left. And let's bring these together now. So I'm going to add a composite. Bring it in at the bottom here. So we've got three inputs for our composite. We have our foreground, we have our background, and we have our matte. And it's really much for muchness which way we order things. So we can either have the original clip as our foreground, and then we use the Roto node to poke a hole in it. So we can just take out our channels and pipe that in there. And then we'll take our transformed area here. And that brings that in there. So let's preview this out. So at the moment, it's just showing us our wire coming through here. We're not really poking holes in things. We're actually almost doing the opposite. We're kind of just filling in the more of the gaps there. So to make it so we're poking a hole in the foreground, we just invert the alpha there. And now when we have a look at that, let's turn off these stabilized viewer, F to go back into full screen. We can start to see that that is working as we need it to. We can also see something that I didn't think we'd have to do. I actually am going to have to paint in the rest of the background up at the top there. Apparently, we're seeing a lot more of the background than I thought we were going to. That's not a problem, obviously. So we just come here, we come to our frame 57. I'm still on my drag tool in the paint. Turn my overlays back on again, drag that out. I'm going to come up to the top here, hold down Control or Command and just scrub back and forth just to come in and make my brush a little bit smaller. There we go. Better. Let's see how that works in the composite now. It's looking better, yeah. We do have a little bit of a hard line on there, but we can always come back to the Roto node and maybe just blur that out just a little bit. Let's turn off the overlay so we can see what that's blurring. Could blur the output of the entire node, which is going to work out all right, I suppose, on this one, but or for this second, but it's not going to look great soon. So we'll do something else soon. And just as I suspected, there is like a little bit of a color shift as well. It's a little bit too pink. That's something else we'll fix. So play that back. And we have now, you know, started to fix up the top lines there. Easy. Now we've created our match moved clean plate and done the initial roto work to completely remove the top wires. After the break, we'll continue on with the Roto and create some hold-in masks for the important elements we're now missing. This lets me talk about different built-in tracking options in Silhouette, and we'll see some fun ways to use different Roto shapes. So I'll see you again in exercise 5.